हाय 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 हेलो
हेलो हेलो हेलो हेलो हेलो हेलो हेलो सर वेलकम आई एम गोइंग टू जस्ट ऐड
हाय एंथनी हाउ आर यू And then your team is from Scotland, Ireland. Can you type the answer here? Welcome, sir. Good evening.
Good evening. Good evening, Samir.
Can you hear me clearly?
Yeah.
Video is good as well?
Yes.
Okay, great.
Perfect.
Let's give it. We are 1 minute early. So we are not on Indian standard time.
I'm always on time.
Right, sir.
I like to be on
one
time.
One message that you can give people. Great.
Always be on time. So,
absolutely. We'll give it a few more minutes and let people join in.
Yeah, sure.
And
sure.
We'll start in a couple of minutes.
No
Hello,
problem.
Vicky. Hi, how are you? Sir, can you see the people joining in as well at the bottom of your screen?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yes.
Okay. So if you see any question that interests you from there, just please feel free to pick up a question. If somebody asks you during our conversation as well.
Okay, sure.
So we have Anthony and I think some of the people from his team will join us from the Adamstown Club from Ireland. Welcome.
Oh, that's great.
Yeah, they're very, very key cricketers
nice.
And they have a they have multiple teams who comprise mostly or a lot of them are from the Asian subcontinent. So they are very, very keen on cricket and they join us. They are players from England, from Ireland, from Scotland, India, Pakistan, Bangladesh as well.
I used to play in Scotland.
Oh, you did, sir. Okay. Okay.
Yeah.
It must have been a really nice experience.
Yeah. I spent around 12 years in England playing Yorkshire League and Bradford League and Scottish League.
Oh, wow. Okay.
Great experience.
Brilliant.
Of playing English cricket. Yeah.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Hi, Hitesh. Welcome. We'll give it one more minute, sir, while both
while
you get comfortable and we also let a few more people join in. And we'll have people coming in and out of the conversation. So, you know, we'll just take a question whenever it's possible. Otherwise, we'll continue to have our chat and we'll pick something interesting if it comes up. Hello. Hi. Welcome back again, Sahil. Hope you're doing well. Great. Okay. So, I'm going to start my timer now, sir, so that we don't get engrossed so much that we lose track of time.
Yeah.
Which generally tends to happen when we're talking about something that we are so passionate about. Okay. So I will, please allow me to do a short introduction, sir. For our viewers, welcome to Pure Cricket once again. Today we are with Sulakshan Kulkarni, sir. For those who are part of the Mumbai cricketing scene, the gentleman who joined us today does not need any introduction. If you played at the Ranji Trophy level anywhere across this country, again, there is no need of introduction for sir. But for the youngsters who have joined in and people who are passionate about cricket, I will still share a small introduction. So, Sulakshan sir obviously is a very well-known cricketer and a coach across this entire country. He has represented the Mumbai Ranji Trophy team for over a decade during his playing career that spanned 17 years from 1985 to 2002. He's also... You know, some other state teams have also had the privilege of him being part of their team and learning from him during those years. So, he has also helped the Vidarbha and Chhattisgarh teams as a coach as well. Sir was a right-handed batsman and wicketkeeper during his playing days. And I'm not saying playing days, they are not gone past him yet because I know he's turned up for a few games in the last few years. So, he's still playing. if I'm not wrong, I think he's turned up for a few league matches as well. So, we'll talk about your fitness, sir, because you have to share your secret later in the course of the day.
Yeah.
Right. So, sir, as a wicketkeeper batsman, he has a batting average of close to 40, which is fantastic. He's got 600s and 1350s in his first class career, spanning 65 matches, and he has a top score of 239, which was for Mumbai in an opening record opening partnership with Wasim Jafar of 459 against Saurashtra. Sir has been the coach of Mumbai Under-19 team, of the Vidarbha state team, of Chhattisgarh state team, Central Zone, as well as the 48th time title winning Mumbai Ranji Trophy team, in which he played a very big pivotal role. Like sir mentioned when we started, he's played internationally a lot. I'm sure those teams have also benefited from his experience. He's also helped the Nepalese national cricket team for a short period of time. Sir has a nickname which is very interesting in the cricketing circles. He is known for his cricketing acumen and strategic planning. He is known in the cricketing circles as the brain. So today we get to pick the brain of the brain a little bit and get to learn from him. Welcome again, sir. Thank you so much. We are very, very happy that you have found the time to join us today. To give you a quick brief of what we have done so far, in the past 6 to 7 sessions, we've spoken about basics of the game. We've spoken about the physical needs of the game, the mental aspects of the game, about the technique that's required to be successful, as well as the history of the game. With you, we would like to talk about the strategy and planning aspect of the game, because we keep hearing how much you have contributed as a player, as a captain, as a coach in this aspect, and it is a very, very important aspect of the game. So without further ado, I will jump into the questions. Please stop me, sir, whenever you feel that you need to add something, hear from you, right? Should we? Okay,
yeah.
Great. So, what does planning and strategy, in your opinion, what does it entail? What does it encompass? What do we mean by planning and strategy?
Hi, first of all, good evening, friends. It's a great opportunity for me to share my experience, cricketing experience, with you guys. And thank you, Samir, for letting me in here. About your question, yes, the planning, the strategy is as important as anything else. Because when you, anywhere you play, or in the corporate field or wherever, you need a planning. With a plan, you can fail. But with no plan, you will always fail. So that is my philosophy. So
right,
you can fail 5, 6, 7 times, but at least for 2, 3 times, 4 times, you will be succeeded. But with no
right
plan, you don't have any options. So you should have a plan and strategy. There are n number of strategy and game plans. N number of strategy before the match, you can have a game plan before the match. You know, so for example, the wicket, the opposition, which ground you are going to play. You are going to play on a turning track. You are going to play on a seaming track. You don't know. For example, for Indian team, when they go to England or New Zealand or Australia or West Indies, they know which part of ground they are going to play and what type of wickets they are going to get. Like recently, we lost to New Zealand, because we are completely exposed. We were not prepared.
Right.
Why? The biggest reason is because before that test series starts, we played T20 and One Days. Which was played by a white ball. The big difference between the red ball and white ball is a huge difference. So red ball doesn't swing much. It's a very hard. It's only when you play 20-20, it's you don't get to swing the ball. You reverse. There is no question of reverse. And the players, there is no slip or attacking field. So you can just lug out. You can play your shots. Sometimes you try to play towards the long on and it may go to third man for a six. And even commentator says, "So what a shot!" So completely it's a different ball game. When it comes to red ball, you have a complete test. That is the quality of a test of each player. That's why they call it a test. You have a three slips and a gully, short leg and backward short leg. And we lost that series very badly recently with a red ball, because many players, they don't have the technique to play against a red ball. We lost not because of the red ball. We didn't lose against New Zealand. We lost mentally also, technically as well as mentally, because we didn't have the proper strategy or the game plan.
Right.
So you
Right.
must have a, you must have a game plan, a strategy, 100% before the start of the game. Because to me, I always feel that you win the match or you have better chance to win the match or the series or the championship before you play, before you start. If you
Correct.
don't have the plan,
Right.
then you have less chance.
Right.
Yeah.
Right. Absolutely, sir. Absolutely. I think you answered a little bit of our second question as well, which was what kind of background work do we need to get the right information to make a plan? So, like you gave the example of New Zealand, would you say that the weather and the wind and the breeze also plays a large factor in during the game?
Yes, very much, very much. I'll give you the example, a good example of another strategy. You take 2011-12 series, England versus India in India. 2011-12, which we lost 2-1 against them. And we lost
Right.
that series after so many years, more than 20 years. We never lost a series in India against any team. Reason,
Right.
we prepare our rank turners. We are king of turners. We know
Yes.
how to play, and opposition they don't they struggle. Yeah, so
Right.
we prepare a rank turner, and we were on that particular tour. We were overconfident, as if we have the greatest batting side in the world. Rahul Dravid, Sachin Tendulkar, Virendra Sehwag, Gambhir, and Lakshman and Dhoni, whatnot, the six best
Right.
batsmen. In spite of that, we lost the series. And that was, I feel, as a coach, that was the greatest example of opposition. I will give complete credit to the opposition, how they prepared, how they made the strategy. And
Right.
before coming to India, England team went to Abu Dhabi to prepare for this series. They
Right.
came 15 days before and played a couple of tests against Pakistan to get the practice, the test match practice. And they played
Right.
against the good quality spinners, Yasir Shah, the leg spinner, and
Right.
quality spinners, and they played against them. They got acclimatized with the weather as well. The Abu Dhabi and
Right.
Indian weather is almost similar, so they got a test match practice, and they came to India with the 3 weeks in ahead, with 15 days in Abu Dhabi and 1 week before the test series.
Right.
Second part is, they knew that what type of wickets they are going to get before the series.
Correct.
They're going to get the rank turners. Yeah.
Correct.
So what plan and strategy did, that was a master plan. They knew that Indian strength, the batsman strength, most of the batsmen, Indian batsmen, over the years, they like to step out and play. They like to move out
Correct.
of the crease and play against the spin. Yeah.
Right.
So
Right.
what they did was, so they had two great spinners. One was a great all-time great spinner, Graham Swan, the off spinner,
Correct.
and the
Right.
other one was Monty Panesar. Monty Panesar was the fastest left-arm spinner, like Ravindra Jadeja.
Okay.
Yeah, so his bowling strategies, bowling trajectories, he doesn't give air. He bowl fast.
Flat. Right.
Yeah, flat. So what happened when someone bowls fast? You don't have time to step out.
Right.
So they play from the crease, and when you are in the crease, you are stuck up. You are half the battle. You are lost.
Right.
Yeah, and mentally, he put Indian batsman on the back foot by playing in the crease.
Right.
So they never allowed any Indian batsman to step out in the entire series. And
Right.
Panesar was bowling accurate on the stump, and not a single batsman used his feet, or he didn't allow them to use the crease,
Use the chip.
including
Yeah.
Tendulkar, the great
Right.
Tendulkar. And they won the series completely 2-1 with the strategy, great strategy. Whereas,
Right.
similarly, as far as batting is concerned, they make a plan or strategy with or against our spinners, R. Ashwin and Pragyan Oja. If you know him, Pragyan Oja, he was a left-arm
Right.
spinner.
Left-arm spinner.
So
Yeah.
again, the master strategy of Kevin Peterson, particularly, that he said after the series got over, he said, "I prepared a strategy against Indian spinners, particularly the left-arm spinner, the Pragyan Oja." He said, "I draw the line. The line is, if he bowls to me inside the line, that means I'll go for a six. I'll go for a big shot. And if anything beyond that line, I'll defend the ball. I'll survive. I'll defend the ball." And in the entire series, he scored 178 at Wankhede Stadium. And he hit 5 to 6 sixes off Pragyan Oza. And then he asked, even though we put 6 fielders on the boundary line. So what did he say, you know? So I never thought of the player, whether where the player is, whether the long off or the long on or the deep middle gate. When I decided to play, that will go to the stadium. That ball will go to the stadium. So that was the strategy. And they made that strategy before the tournament, before the series. And this helps. So that is what I wanted to tell you. The strategy helps. The strategy has to have.
Absolutely.
To prepare
Absolutely,
yourself.
Sir.
Yeah.
Absolutely. Yeah. Sir, you are predicting what questions I'm going to ask because you have answered one part of it for the next question again. So everybody who is there can see what foresight sir has already. I was going to ask you for a few examples of strategies that change the course of the game, which you have already talked to us about. So I'll move to the next question, but we can come back to this when, you know, if you have more interesting ones to share with us, we'll be more than happy to listen to this. One thing that I want to do is I want to congratulate you for winning the World Cup for us last year, the World Series. I think, unfortunately, there was not enough coverage that should have been there for that World Series. The Indian differently abled team won the 2019 World Series in England last year. Fantastic win. And when we spoke to Amog in our second session, Amog did mention that we had some disadvantages there over some other teams in terms of how physical disability was defined. How was it, sir? That, first of all, congratulations. Thank you so much for bringing pride to the nation.
Thank you.
How was that? Obviously was a big challenge, sir. How did you manage that? How did you motivate the boys? And what was the experience like?
This was something great experience of my life. Probably the 40 years of cricket, I never experienced such a type of, you know, the experience with these boys. And I'll tell you what able people could not do, the disabled people could do to win the World Cup in England. And that too in England. You know, the same place.
Right.
And this was some challenge. Because, you know, sometimes we call it, naturally it comes from the mouth. Are zara jhukke khelo yaar. Bend and play. Thoda jhukke khelo yaar. But what is jhukke khelo? I can tell the normal people. But these some people, they have amputated a leg or a hand. Or some people, they don't have the proper fingers. And it was very difficult for a batsman to, you know, bend and play. They have some problem. So then I realized, this is a very big problem. And particularly playing in India, England, when ball is moving, you know.
Yes.
So they cannot bend and play. So instead of that, I told him, okay, let the ball come to you instead of you going to the ball.
Right.
So that can be done. That can be adjusted.
Correct.
So if you go towards the ball, there will be a big gate, you know, between bat and pad. So instead of that, you let the ball come to you and then you can play. And in 2020, you hardly get those type of balls. Yeah.
Right.
So that was the biggest challenge. But in spite of that, another challenge was we have a disability criteria of, you know, there was no fixed criteria of disability criteria. We have 40% of disability with English team has only 15%. So there was a huge gap. Yes.
Right.
There was a huge gap. Yeah. And they were super fit guys, English players. But with the sheer guts, the determination, the skill level, and the tactics. Again, I'll tell you the tactics, the strategy. And that strategy, the master strategy worked. As you said in the introduction, the brain behind the strategy. And that strategy in every match worked. You know, I sent in one match against Afghanistan, we were chasing 80 and we were 5 for 4 wickets. And in the dressing room, yes, five runs and 4 wickets. And we were struggling. In the dressing room, the mood was different. So at that particular stage, I sent number 10 batsman at number 6. So everyone was very, you know, surprised. So why did you send this guy at number 6? So I said, just give me some time. Just wait for a moment. I was playing a gamble then. Even if he gets out, doesn't matter. Because as it is, he's a number 10 batsman. But if he stays there for another 20-30 minutes, that crucial phase is out.
Okay.
And he stayed there with our captain. He stayed there till the end and we were 84-4 and we won the match. That was a spontaneous tactic. Yeah, but that was some experience.
Brilliant, sir. Brilliant, brilliant.
Yeah.
You've got Yashwant from Andhra is saying hello to you, sir.
Yeah. Hi, Yashwant.
Okay, sir. Wonderful, wonderful. I saw pictures of that.
Yeah,
I saw the celebration.
Yeah, Samir, sorry. Yashwant, yeah, I know now. Yashwant, yes. And he was, when I was a Ranji Trophy coach of Mumbai, we played a couple of games in Vizag. That time he was an under 14 guy. And he was a wicket keeper. Okay. He came to me for, you know, to get the tips. Yeah, after right. We are meeting here after 10 to 12 years.
Okay.
Yeah, good.
Great. Great to have you, Yashwant. Thank you for being part of the session for us. Thank you. Sir, please, Sahil is asking for, sir, please, some drills to do at home for a batsman. What would you recommend, sir?
Sahil, I don't know you are what type of player you are, or if you are a basic player, if you are advanced player, depend on the quality of, you know, the what type of player you are. If you are a good player, if you are a regular player, then do the regular drills what you have been doing, and see that, you know, suppose if you are a good player, you are going to represent your state, then what type of planning you require. Suppose you are an opening batsman or a middle order batsman, you are required to play against a fast bowler, swing bowler. You can do the hanging ball drills at home. You can imagine, you can visualize that you are going to play against this type of bowler at, I don't know which level, you are under 19 or under 16 or open category. I always say that under 19 and above is open category. So right. you might get 130 bowlers, 130 kph bowler, or maybe 140 kph bowler. So visualize at home, and in front of the mirror, you visualize that someone is bowling at 140 outside the off stump. Leave the ball, play the ball, play the shot, and like that. Spinners with the spin, the left arm spinner, leg spinner, off spinner with the field, you can visualize and you can make a story at home, and you can build your inning. I used to do it regularly. Even Sachin Tendulkar used to do it. Sachin Tendulkar right. used to practice at 2 o'clock, four o'clock midnight for the next test match.
Right.
Yeah.
Right.
So you can practice at home as per your game.
Right.
Yeah.
So Sahil
yeah.
is an under 14 player. He is an upcoming aspiring cricketer. But what sir says applies to any level of cricket. It is that if you are under 14, obviously you are not going to face somebody who is bowling at 130.
Yeah.
But you could take the basic guidelines that sir was talking about, and what we say, you know, practice with the hanging ball or practice in front of the mirror. Imagine what the field placement is going to be, the bowlers are going to be, and you know, then accordingly adjust and practice your game. Sir, you were also the coach when Mumbai won their 40th title in 2012-2013, right, sir? That year?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yes.
So how did it feel, sir? You played for Mumbai for so long, and you would have been part of the winning teams as a player, and then to coach that very team to the trophy.
Very good question, Samir. That was my dream. To play for Mumbai, that was my dream. When I was 13, when I first entered Wankhede Stadium at 13 for under 15 selection, when I saw the Wankhede Stadium for the first time in my life, and at other end, I was watching a Mumbai Ranji Trophy team with a Sunil Gavaskar, Dilip Pengsarkar and Ravi Shastri. The all big players were practicing at the other end. And at other side, we were having a under 15 selection. That moment inspired me a lot, the stadium and the players. And that moment, I realized, suppose if I play on this wicket, on this ground one day, what will happen? So I was just visualizing. And I got the inspiration from there on. And then, playing for Mumbai, sharing that dressing room with the greats like Gavaskar, Vengsarkar, Shastri, and then Tendulkar, Manjrekar, Kambli, and whatnot. We won 3 times Ranji Trophy and 3 times Irani Trophy, 6 championships. I was a witness as a player, but I always dreamt of, you know, having coach of this team. Someday I'll coach this team, and again I'll win the Ranji Trophy as a coach. That was something. During my phase as a coach, luckily, I had a very good team. First year, they were not. But we built the team. And then second year, luckily, I got the players. Sachin played all the matches, most of the matches. Rarely it happened. Sachin played 5 matches, including quarterfinal to semifinal. And that was some experience sharing with Sachin Tendulkar, Zahir Khan, Ajit Agarkar, as a captain. Samir, I'll tell you here, sometimes you feel lucky to have a great captain. And I played under 22 captains. That is something, you know, to play under 22 various captains, yes.
Right.
But I reckon two great captains I played under, I rate them two best. First is Ravi Shastri, and the second one is Ajit Agarkar. And he was there as a captain. Yes. And he led the team brilliantly. And, you know, when you get the brilliant captain, shrewd captain, your job is nothing. You just sit and watch and enjoy the game with all these players. Yes, we struggled in the, Samir, we struggled in the league phase. At one stage, we were out of the tournament. And one game, I'll tell you, the reason before winning the tournament, we played our second last league match and we were almost out of the tournament with opposition required only 6 runs to win. That particular batsman hit 4 consecutive sixes of Abhishek Nair and we put all the fielders on the boundary line. 9 fielders on the boundary line. And on the 5th ball, the non-striker came running to him, that batsman, and told him that, you know, you just take a single, I'll survive for one ball. Again, you can play and get the runs and we can win. But this person, he was in different mood. He was in different planet. So he said, ke, chalo, abhi marenge yaar, 5-6 marenge, aur match karenge, match hum log jitenge, which style? Khatam karenge. And he got out on the 5th ball, a deep extra cover. And we won that match by 6 runs. So when everyone came in the dressing room, I said, now the trophy is ours. Nobody can beat us. And we won the trophy. that was some experience.
Okay. Great. Thank you. It felt like we were with you at this point time when you were kind of describing it for us. So one question that, not really a question, but it is surprising and not a lot of us would have heard about Ajit Agarkar being a good captain. Can you share some more insight on that?
Yes. Why I'm saying he's one of the best captain is, I always read the good captain should be a bowler's captain. Always good captain should be a bowler's captain. Why? Because always cricket game is win by a bowler, not a batsman.
Right.
You may score 600 or 800 or someone gets 400.
Right.
I'm not bothered. But who is going to take 20 wickets?
Correct.
To take 20 wickets, you need a bowler's captain. And you got to help this bowler, your main bowlers, whatever. Sometimes you may not get your main bowlers to get wickets. Sometimes he get hit for, you know, few boundaries. Sometimes his morale is down. So that time, his shrewd captain or a great captain goes to him. Never mind. This happens because you are going to bowl a 3 or 4 spell in a day. So one or two spells, they might go wrong. But then you can come back. That's why I rate him a very good captain. And he was very shrewd. He was encouraging all the time to bowlers. Batsman is very easy. You know, when you have a batsman like Sachin Tendulkar, Rohit Sharma, Ajinkya Rahane, Wasim Jafar, your job is zero. You don't have to tell them how to score.
Correct.
The main job is to take 20 wickets and tell your bowler, just calm down. I'm there. Just calm down. You are my best bowler. That's why we picked you in the team. Your job is to take wicket. And he did it. That's why.
So true. So true. Thank you, sir. Thanks for sharing that perspective.
Yeah.
Okay. We'll come to the next one. You have also coached, besides Central Zone, you have also coached Vidarbha and Chhattisgarh. Okay. The culture of cricket is very different in different parts of this country. The language is very different. How different was you for, you know, from a culture, from a language barrier standpoint to work with those teams?
Yes, Samir. This is a different challenge because a developing team like Mumbai, the developed team like a Mumbai and a developing team like Chhattisgarh and Vidarbha is a different challenge, different culture. Different culture basically is a different mindset. I was a coach of Vidarbha in 2009-10 in the initial years. You know, and that time they didn't have a overall professional setup.
Right.
Now is just stories are different, completely different. In those days, we didn't have a specific, you know, the setup, professional setup. And the biggest challenge was their mindset. Before that, 2010, in 70 years of cricket, Vidarbha hardly qualified for the knockout.
Correct.
Forget about winning the championship. And when you don't have any trophy in your showcase, it is very difficult to motivate them.
Correct.
But when I was a coach, we did extremely well to reach the semi-finals, won the T20 and a one-day semi-final, you know, and they did very well. They had a good confidence. And then Chhattisgarh, I was there in 2016-17. That was a very new team. The first time they played a Ranji Trophy. Right. To build an inning, build a team of a new side, young side, you know, with inexperience. Still in 6 months, I built that team. You know, we won the Buchi Babu Trophy. If you heard, Buchi Babu is a very famous tournament, All India tournament in Chennai.
Right, sir.
We won the Buchi Babu and the Nagpur tournament, Bapuna League. We beat top teams. And to win those tournaments within 6 months, it's a big, big thing, you know.
Right.
But developing side like a Chhattisgarh is a big challenge. But now they are doing extremely well, especially Vidarbha.
Right. And I was reading up upon this about this, sir, and I saw, like you said, 70 years of history, and them not being anywhere close to the top performing teams. And for since the time I think you had a coaching stint with them, they've been quite impressive with their results. So I that's the kind of difference that. A great coach can do in making sure that not just that when he or she is at the particular location coaching that team, but changing the culture of that team to continue to do well. And that's the kind of DNA that sir has helped build in the sides that he has worked with so far. Great. Thank you, sir. I'm coming to you now as a player, sir. you've been a wicketkeeper during your career, quite successful. And a lot of times we talk about how much of the action the wicketkeeper sees and is able to judge and therefore influence the course of the game. So in your opinion, how much of this is true? Because how much of a contribution does a wicketkeeper make given that they have the best view of the field? Mahendra Singh Dhoni, Adam Gilchrist, you can name a few cricketers who are extremely shrewd and led their teams. So what is your perspective on this, sir?
Yes, it's a very good question, Samir, again. Yes, wicketkeeper can be the center point of the game, always. Because he has the best view, and he can see the view. Plus, he can tell the captain, he can give inputs to the captain or a senior player, you know, or a bowler for that matter. And he is the only person from the best view that, you know, he can guide, he can help your captain or a team or a coach.
Right.
But provided, I say provided, if he has that knack, then only. There are so many wicket keepers I have seen. They have been playing for n number of years. But in spite of that, they don't have that knack. You should be very street smart. And you should know, read the game. You know, read the game. Yeah, what is happening? What the bounce, the turn, the slip fielder, where he should stand. You know, if you get a good bounce, the silly point, short leg, backward short leg, the slip, you know, where they should stand. And if the bounce is low, where they should stand, they should come up one step or two steps. It all depends. These are the finer points of the game. And then the two gaps of cricket, I always say for a wicketkeeper, there are two gaps, cover and mid-off, mid-wicket and mid-on. These are the two gaps wicketkeeper can see. And wicketkeeper can help a captain, you know, there is a big gap. I helped many captains, Ravi Shastri, Dilip Vengsarkar, Sachin Tendulkar, Manjrekar, you know, when I was playing as a wicketkeeper or either as a batsman for Mumbai.
Right.
And I helped them to, you know, Dilip see the gap. And they had a faith. And they should also have a faith in wicketkeeper. And once you have that understanding or faith, then sometimes the captain say, "Arey, tere ko jo lagta hai wo karo, karo," because they have a faith in you.
True.
And they realize, yes, and above all, you can give them the proper inputs. Ki, okay, abhi kya ho raha hai? Now you can give that he's tired, this bowler is tired. You can make out that this bowler is tired. He's into sixth over or seventh over. So don't push him. Just give him time. Right. You know, sometimes you just go to the bowler and keep a hand on in his shoulder and say, okay, can you bowl one more over? I used to do it. I used to do it regularly with the Mumbai team or, you know, Abhi Kurvila, Abhi Paras. They were my teammates. And though they were tired, even captain said, ki, yaar, bus, Abhi bus. Okay. Abhi, next over, you are coming from that end. And Paras was bowling. And I knew that if Paras bowl one more over, we might get a wicket. And that time after the over, I used to go to Paras or Abby. Abby, A4 डालेगा तो विकेट मिलेगा यार. मेरे को लगता है तेरे को विकेट मिलेगा और अपने को जरूरत है विकेट का. A4 and you can do it, I think. That small things, you know, make a huge difference.
Absolutely.
And these wicketkeeper can give inputs.
Yeah. It's wonderful to hear all of these insights from you, sir, because, you know, we see what we see on TV and we only understand what we see and partly from games that we watch on the field otherwise, but getting an in-depth insight from somebody who's done this is really, really very enlightening, sir. So I thank you so much for sharing all of this with us.
Pleasure.
Okay. I have a couple more questions. We have about 20 minutes remaining. I have a couple more questions for you. You also hold a world record in Ranji Trophy, sir.
You're
only the second wicket keeper and the fourth in the world to score 100 and take 6 catches in an innings in the same match. So can you tell us what that that entire sequence was? And you are an extremely rare company, so I just want to know what your thoughts are on that.
Yeah, I'll tell you the interesting story, Samir. Before going into this, actually I was dropped for this game.
Okay.
I was dropped for this game and I was so shocked to hear that, you know, because normally Mumbai announced the team day before. Suppose tomorrow we have a game, previous day we practice and after the practice we have a team meeting and a captain or a coach announced the team. And I was not there in the playing 11. And when I heard that I'm not in the playing 11, I was in shell shock. And I came to the Churchgate station. At a station, I sit down for there for 45 minutes, you know, and I was so shattered at that particular situation. And then at night, same night at around 9:30, my coach called me that, you know, our main wicketkeeper, our first wicketkeeper is not well. He had some food poison and then you are playing. So that was that, you know, the destiny. The destiny was there. So I told my wife that time, you know, I got the opportunity now and I'll ensure that, you know, I will not waste it. So tomorrow you see this different, something different is coming. I said to my wife and first I kept the wickets and I was in different mood there entire match. Maybe I was, not very happy being dropped and my feet movement, I was going excellent when I was. That particular day, I can tell you, I was a natural wicketkeeper. I was a natural wicketkeeper, means I was an all-round wicketkeeper. Good, equally good against fast and spin, you know. And that particular day, my feet was moving like, nothing. Brilliant. And I got 6 catches the same day. And before 10 minutes before tea, they were all out. Haryana team got all out. And I went with my mate, Manoj Joglekar. You must have heard his name. Partner, opening partner. Yes. And I made sure that particular 10 minutes, I went without a helmet. Even he reminded me that, Sulu, you're not wearing helmet. Well, today not. I'm in different mood. So the moment I went in, so Haryana players said, "Are helmet nahi pehna, iske takle pe dena." I was expecting the bouncers. I was expecting the bouncer. And first 3 ball, he bowled bouncer. I hit for 3 fours. 3 hook shots, 3 boundaries. And then after T to end, that is 1.5 hour session, I scored 100. I scored 120.
Phenomenal.
And I didn't realize I got out for 120, but I didn't realize what was the score or record. But next day it came in the paper. Someone told me that this was the second best in the India and fourth best in the world. So that was some, the gift. Wow. Something special. Yeah.
Amazing. Amazing. I think the point that people should keep in mind is even at the time when you were maybe slightly upset or something and you went into the bat, even then there was a strategy not to use the helmet. So you knew what was coming to you, right?
Yes.
So you were well prepared for
that. Yes, correct.
So fantastic example of turning adversity into benefit for your own self and for the team as well. So fantastic, sir. Wonderful, wonderful example for people out there to know how you can turn things around for yourself. When the opportunity arrives, you never know. It's destiny. Either you can be upset about it and then not do anything, or completely, grab it with both hands and do what's
Correct.
urgent. Get an
No, always
account.
you should be always positive. Yes, you should be always positive because you know negative minds never helps.
True. True, sir. Absolutely.
Negative minds never
Absolutely.
helps.
I have two more questions for you. I'm looking at the time. We have about 18 minutes, so we have time. What advice would you give, sir, to budding captains, you know, under 14, under 16, under 19, age group, basically, captains, because I believe by the time you get to first-class cricket, you have a fair bit of experience, maybe not as a captain or maybe as a captain at the age group levels. But what kind of advice would you give for captains who are in the age group levels, under 14, 16, 19, 22?
Yeah. At age group level, even I won't consider 19 and 22. I consider 19 as a main.
True. Yeah, you said that.
14, 16, yes. I would advise all the captains to first enjoy the game. First enjoy the game. Forget about captaincy. Mm-hmm. First enjoy the game. You have come on the ground. You have 11 players or 15 players. And you enjoy the game. Enjoy the moment. And make sure that, you know, you give opportunity to equal opportunity to everyone. You know, they should get the opportunity. End of the day, when they go home, they should tell their parents or their friends, you know, today I got the bowling or the fielding or wicket keeping, whatever. I got the share. You know, it's not only two bowlers are bowling or, you know, one or two batsmen. Yeah, it can happen. When you play a tournament, it can happen if you score 100 and 100 for no loss. But while bowling, you can at least give something to the bowlers also. And you give respect to the all players. You know, and play in the right spirit of the game. Because always they should remember that game is greater than the player.
Absolutely, sir. Absolutely.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
So just enjoy the game. And when you watch the matches, I always say that when I was very young, I used to observe, I used to watch the game. In those days, they were not a telephone or a smartphone or a television like that. But we used to watch, we used to visualize. Now, since you have everything in the, you know, at your fingertips. But you can observe T20, one day or test match, you can observe and you can, you know, take the cues from the captain. Yeah?
Absolutely. 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 We have one question from Raj. Raj says, you just gave an example of when you were dropped for a game, but fortunately you got an opportunity. There are several times in the career of, you know, such a long career when you may have been picked, may not have been picked. And with other, you must have seen other players also. As a coach, you may have picked somebody, not picked somebody, and they would have come back and done well. So Raj's question is, how do you keep yourself motivated when you're not part of the playing 11 or have been dropped from the side altogether? What would you do to keep, what should one do to keep themselves motivated?
First and foremost thing is stay positive. Number one. Number two, believe in yourself. Number two, first is stay positive. Number two, believe in yourself. Just tell yourself that you belong to this place. That's why you are there.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
That's why you are there. And, you know, success and failure, they are part of the, you know, the life.
True.
But you be there. You believe yourself that, yes, one day, next day is mine. Today is not mine. Maybe next day. But then today, don't go to bed and just sleep. Go to the nets, hit the nets and do the basics and hit even harder. So that it will help you, you know, when you get the opportunity.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
That is my message to any youngster.
Absolutely. So true, sir. So true. And a lot of times people just let adversity get the better of them. And instead of sulking about why I was not picked or why I was not given a chance, you should just go back and work that much more harder. We've seen several examples of this in international teams as well. When people have been dropped, certain people have just phased out. Others have come back much more stronger than they were.
Yes.
Perfect.
Samir, if there is a 1 minute time, can I take a 1 minute, just 1 minute?
Absolutely. Yes, sir. Definitely.
My greatest idol in this particular, of this particular question is the greatest idol is Mohinder Amarnath, whom I idolize and whom I say ki he is a comeback man of a comeback. He has made comeback after comeback. And for your information, for Mumbai only, I made 7 comebacks.
Fantastic.
7 comebacks in 15 years. To make a debut is quite easy, but to make a comeback is very difficult. and I made 7 comebacks, and it's very difficult. One comeback was after 5 years, and after 5 years I made comeback for Mumbai and went on to play for 7 years with all these greats, Sachin Tendulkar and all these great players. So it's not very easy. You have to believe yourself.
Absolutely, absolutely. And to come back into a Mumbai side that is packed with stars who are playing for the country at that point of time is an incredible feat, sir. So I think there's a lot that people can learn from you. If you, Raj, if you just follow sir's career on online, just go and check, you will know about what sir was talking now. And the team that he played in, extremely, extremely tough side to get in. It was like if you got into that side, you almost are playing for India. More than half of the side was playing for India at that point of time.
Yes.
Right. Next aspect of your game, sir, what would you advise people who would like to take up coaching as a career?
Yes, definitely. But for that, one should ask himself that what quality I have. Do I have that quality? The first and foremost thing is ability.
Right.
Do you have the ability? You ask a question yourself and you will get the answer. Yes or no. If you have, yes. Okay, I have the coaching ability means I have the requirement. I have the basic knowledge of the game.
Right.
Question is yes. Answer is yes. Okay, go ahead. Do I have the passion? Answer is yes. Go ahead. The dedication, the time I'm going to spend, and whether I am willing to learn. That is the most important. I'm learning today. I'm learning every day and every moment. And if you are willing to learn, then you can do a lot of things.
Right.
So
sir,
for a coach, you should be able to, you know, learn a lot of things. You get information from, you know, talking with the senior players, or you can watch the match. You get a lot of things.
Right.
Yeah. Yeah. But for that, when you talk to yourself that you are going to teach a student who may be 8 years old or 10 years old or 12 years old, you know, you should be able to give him proper time and a proper coaching.
Right.
And if you don't understand, don't give that you know, the coaching to that boy when you don't know the answer.
Right. Right.
That is I say that is a crime. Aadha gyan baatna sahi nahi hai.
Bilkul sahi.
So you talk to your friend or a senior person and get the advice and then talk to that boy.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
Yeah.
And also, sir, one thing that I'd like to share from my end also is that, you know, playing cricket and being able to coach somebody are not the same thing. You need a certain ability, like sir said, not just to understand the game, but also to convey it in the right manner to your audience. So you might be a brilliant batsman, but if you are not able to explain to the student what needs to happen and what they need to follow or need to do and correct them and convey it in the right manner, you are not going to be successful as a coach. Right. Go on, sir.
Samir, I'll take just 1 minute here.
Sure.
I have seen many greats in international cricket and in Indian cricket, though they have played outstanding cricket. But it is not necessary that they may be a good coach or a good selector or a good captain for that matter.
True.
They are outstanding.
Absolutely.
Yeah. So same thing happened with the coaching. In India, in last 100 years of coaching, 100 years, I will tell the grassroots level and the basic level, they have produced great players like Kapil Dev, Gavaskar or Virat Kohli and Tendulkar. Sachin Tendulkar's coach was Ramakant Acharekar, sir, who never played any first class cricket. Hello?
Unfortunately, it looks like we have lost connection with sir. We'll try and get him on the phone and see if we can reconnect with him. I'm trying to do that right now. Baba, kuni connect kela kaise? हाँ सर, आई लॉस्ट कनेक्शन आई थिंक, इधर यू और मी. अच्छा, आई रिसेंट यू एन इनवाइट. वी माइट हैव अ फ्यू मोर मिनट्स, कपल मोर मिनट्स रिमेनिंग. जस्ट प्लीज ट्राई एंड जॉइन यू सर. थैंक यू. खिलाएगा चलो. नहीं, बंदा खिलाएगा. Yeah, sorry, we are trying to get sir back. Let's see if we can get him back. Not sure what's happening. We'll see. Anthony, can you hear me? Krish, can you hear me? Okay, some reason